Welcome to Rashi, Parasha Study, Parashat Devarim. Today we're going to see just one comment of Rashi, a small comment that answers a big question within the text, and it serves as a foundation for a very important wide range of possibilities within Judaism. We have Moshe being commanded, go hitgarbo milhama to Sihon, the king of Heshbon. Hashem is actually commanding Moshe to go and fight Sihon, start a war with him. I'm giving him into your hands. And then, very oddly, so Hashem finishes speaking to Moshe, and the next pasuk we see, he says, Ba'ishlach malachim el Sihon melech ha'emori. I sent messengers to Sihon, mimidbar kidemot, divrei shalom lemor. I sent him words of peace. Please let me go through your land. So Rashi assumes that this is a contradiction to Hashem's words. Hashem told him, go fight. Moshe instead actually offers peace. I want to make peace with you. Please let me travel to your city. I'll offer you money for food and water. And a direct contradiction to what Hashem says. So Rashi comments on the words of Mimidbar Kedemot, which we don't actually see. We don't know what this place of Midbar Kedemot actually is. And he says, Afal pi shelo sivani hamakom likro l'sihon l'shalom. Even though Hashem didn't command me to call out offer peace to Sihon, lamadi Mimidbar Sinai. I learned from Midbar Sinai, Mimidbar, which Midbar Sinai, min ha-Torah shekadma le'olam, from Midbar Kedemot, reference to the Midbar Sinai, in which the Torah, which is kadma le'olam, which preceded the world, came from. That's what Midbar Kedemot. What did Moshe learn from Midbar Sinai, min ha-Torah shekadma le'olam? When he came to give the Torah, he asked Esav, he asked Ishmael if they would want the Torah, right, based off the famous derasha of Hashem Sinai Ba'av Zerach B'Seir Lamo Hufiyah Ma'al Paran in the beginning of Vizot HaBeracha. He offered it to the children of Esav, the children of Ishmael, meaning the Abraham family. And I know, and Hashem knew, they weren't going to say yes, but yet he went out of his way to do it anyway. Afal pi patach lahim l'shalom. He offered them the Torah. Afani kidamti Sihon b'divrei shalom. So too, that's what I did as well. I know he's not going to accept. Hashem already told me he's giving us the land. Obviously, there's going to be a fight, but it's, in a sense, irrelevant. Hashem taught us that we offer shalom even when we know it's not going to be accepted. Rashi then brings another explanation with Bar Kedemot. He says, I learned from Hashem who sent me from the Midbar to be Mekadem Paro b'shalom, to ask him to send my people in peace, even though HaKadosh Baruch Hu could have sent one lightning bolt and destroyed all of Egypt right away. Instead, he offered them, he said, send my people. He saw it was a little plague, a small, bigger plague, a little bit, but not getting to destruction until only plague 10, when they constantly refused. So Moshe is saying, listen, Hashem, I know you didn't ask me to do this, but I looked at what you do. I saw you always offer shalom. And therefore, I learned to offer Sihon shalom. Now, what Moshe is telling us is something fascinating. And based off this Rashi, this means that even when Hashem directly tells us to do something, it doesn't mean that we should exclude the rest of the ideas that we know in the Torah. They still have to work within the greater framework of the ideas of the Torah. And if the ideas of the Torah are preaching peace, and here Hashem is going to war, okay, go to war, only after you ask for peace, which you should know from elsewhere in the Torah. And it's something very fascinating that the Torah, Moshe, Rashi, is teaching us to do. Always identify the greater framework of Torah and apply it to situations in which it wasn't said beforehand. And you have to have that ability to do that. Just like Moshe Rabbeinu learning what to do based on previous understandings of Hashem, so do we. Hashem doesn't tell us everything. He gave us certain ideas, and we have to figure out how to apply them properly and appropriately. And that's the beauty of learning Torah Sheba'al Peh and attempting to apply the themes that apply throughout the Torah to the rest of the Torah. I hope we can appreciate all this message of Rashi, and Shabbat Shalom, and Siskul Lir'ot, and Hamat Siyon. Amen.